Is that all you're having?
When Bob comes over tonight, the least I can guarantee him is a flat stomach. Oh, it seems like a lifetime since he was last here.
You really like him, don't you?
Well, of course I do. He's a dream come true. Not doing anything tonight, are you?
No, why?
I thought I'd cook us all a meal, celebrate Bob moving in. He likes my cooking, does Bob?
He's moving in? Have you spoke to him then?
No, but I know it's what he wants. From the first moment we met, it was clear to me we'd end up cohabiting.
Well, don't you think you'd jump in the gun a bit? Like, scare him off, he might not want that sort of commitment.
Killy, bless you for your concern, and I know you got me best interests at heart, but trust me, me and Bob, we have reached a true understanding.
Will you be getting rid of Dad's stuff to make room for Bob?
Well, you can't live in the past forever. Your dad's gone and I'm still here. You do understand, don't you?
Yeah, of course.
It's what we've been missing. A man about the house.
Only 2 days to go now. Yeah. I was just thinking the same thing.
I miss having Bernice here terribly. Plus, of course, having you here has made me want a home all the more.
I am doing the right thing, aren't I?
Are you having doubts?
She might not want to know me.
Oh, if that was the case, I'd never have contacted you. Bernice told me she's always regretted not having known a full family.
She never actually said that she wanted to come face to face with her father.
Well, not in so many words, no. But I'm sure it'll be a wonderful surprise.
I hope so. It's going to be very hard, that first meeting. What are we going to do? Have me sat in a chair and her come through the door with you doing the introductions?
That would be one option, though perhaps that would be a little awkward. I think it might be best if we have a think, consider all the options.
There you are! Been shouting for you this past 10 minutes. Started to think you'd been eaten up by one of those cows.
I think it might be a bit tough for them.
I don't know how you can do it, Jack. Honest, I don't. It's not just the smell. They frighten me to death. And if people think sheep are timid, you want to try putting me in a field full of them?
Anyone would think I worked in a safari park.
You do. With, I might add, a minefield for a walkway. It's only my skill at hopscotch stopped these till he's been covered in you-know-what.
Have you ever thought of doing stand-up comedy?
From what I've read, most of the greats only joked to cover up the pain.
Is that what you do?
Maybe it's quite a lot at the moment.
You all right?
I will be. To be honest, I came up here for a break. I need cheering up, and you seem to be the only man that can do it for me.
Let me guess. Rodney.
I don't think Ashley realises what he's doing.
When's Bernice back?
Friday. Oh, Jack, I'm that agitated.
No, sounds of your control by the sounds of things.
I thought I might go and see Ashley later. Try and persuade him one last time to tell Rodney it's a bad idea and to go.
Well, I wish I could be more help. Look, I'm due a break. Fancy a coffee?
Is that the best you can offer?
Well, it's a bit early for drinking, 10 o'clock.
It wasn't drinking I had in mind. It's a curious thing, but I've never actually had a roll in the hay.
Well, I think it's an expression more than anything else.
How about it?
We can't go in the hayloft.
Of course we can. Or are you telling me you're too old and boring?
Right. That does it.
Won't be any chickens about, will there?
I'll be the envy of every woman with him under my roof. Mind you, I've always inspired jealousy.
Are you sure Bob's not just using you? It's only been a few weeks and you've hardly seen him. Are you sure you're the only one?
I don't share my men.
Yeah, but I don't know what he gets up to. If you asked him how he feels?
Bob's actions speak louder than any words.
And if he does move in, then how do you know he won't want to bring all his kids with him? We'll be crowded out.
We'll manage if necessary. You and his daughter can share a room.
You've only just met him. He might be a pervert for all I know.
Oh, Kelly, as if. Bob is every woman's fantasy. And a true gent. You take that as gospel. Of all the fish in the sea, this man is a rare catch, and there is none with a rod and line as particular as mine.
No, nor as frequently cast. Where's your bleach?
You dealt with Adelaide the other day.
I just thought it was best to check up on her.
Thanks for your concern. But you know you don't need an excuse to come and visit us, Paddy. As far as we're concerned, you'll always be a dingle.
That's really kind of you, Zach, but I'm just happy being a Kirk. And that's not to say that I don't feel close to you all.
No, I know what you're saying. You want to stay your own man?
Something like that. Yeah?
Well, how much do we owe you for sorting Adelaide out?
Just call it a family favour.
No, it's not. Ah,
there you are. Did you have a good morning in Horton?
Yes, it was wonderful to get out.
You can say
things. No. It wasn't really out I fancied. Other than the Chanel suit. But I thought to myself, no. Wait till Alan asks you what you want for your birthday.
He didn't waste any time then. It's been like something out of Lolita in here the past quarter of an hour.
I didn't think it was my place to say anything.
No, well, that's you all over, isn't it, Alan Turner? Far too backward at coming forward. Put me right off my port.
He's probably using exactly the same patter he tried on me all those years ago. Maybe one of us should warn her. Oh, let him get on with it. When he's in his 70s, he'll still be convincing himself he can pull him.
Are you all right, Anna?
I could murder him for what he's put me through. I could, honest.
Afternoon, Alan. Ah, just who I was looking for.
And you're just who I was looking for. A word, please, Ashley.
Yes, of course.
Not yet, out the back. Right then. I think it's about time we brought this nightmare to a close.
You're talking about Rodney?
Yes, of course I'm talking about Rodney! Who else would I be talking about?
You want him to go, I know.
Ashley, Bernice will not want to meet him. I'm telling you, and I'm telling you because as a mother, I know she will not thank you for this.
You might be her mother, Diane, but I'm about to marry Bernice, so I'd like to think I know her rather well myself.
You've known her for 2 years! And you've no right dragging up the past.
Bernice has a right to meet her father.
Well, she's managed all right without him up till now.
That's no reason to deny her this opportunity.
Ashley, if you knew Bernice even half as well as I do, you'd know to get rid of him. And are you really so sure she'll still want to go ahead and marry you when you've put her through this?
All right, I'll talk to Rodney. I'll tell him maybe it's not such a good idea.
Thank you.
You sure it's not too short? Too showy?
It's not unlike what you generally wear. Viv, will you stop worrying? If he likes you enough to move in, he's hardly going to do a U-turn because of your outfit.
I think the top's a bit tarty. 2 ticks.
Is he staying for long this time, then? Viv's fancy man.
She says he'll be moving in.
Already? Oh, she's a fast mover.
Mrs. Windsor says it's called kismet.
Aye, or a last stab. See you later.
Now, girls, what do you think?
Surprise, surprise! I got off early!
Oh, it's so good to see you! Thing is, I've got my hair to sort.
It was no matter, I can hang on. Not as if it's a flying visit.
Quite. Well, I tell you what, why don't you go across to the Woolpack and I'll meet you there when I've sorted everything out. Kelly can go with you. Keep you company.
I could always hang on.
No, no, you go for a drink, that's all right, isn't it, Kelly?
Fine.
Nice outfit.
Are you all right? Dead quiet.
Just not looking forward to going home, that's all.
Why not?
Bob's due back tonight. Mum says he's moving in. She didn't even ask us what we thought. It's like we don't even count.
Have you talked to her about it?
What's the point? I don't get you anywhere. It's my home.
Well, you can come back to ours for a bit if you want. I'll even cook you dinner if you like.
Hi.
Oh, hiya.
Hi, Thanks so much for the other day. You were fantastic with the kids.
I won't go that far.
No, actually, you're right. You should be struck off. You were terrible. No, seriously, it was really good of you. I don't suppose you'd be interested in helping us out some more, would you? We need someone to come and pick a winner for the school science project.
Oh, you want me to be a judge?
You're the perfect person. Half of them already know you, which helps.
Well, of course I'll do it. Yeah, I'd love to.
Great.
Oh, she's been in and out of blouses all afternoon. Anybody would think it was Robert Redford she were expecting. She's like a stuck record. Bob this, Bob that. Who do you keep smiling at, Diane Blackstock?
It's my facial exercises. Helps keep the skin taut whilst making me look like a happy bunny. It's never too late to start them, Edna.
Is she saying I'm not cheery?
Just thought I'd better tell you, you've got a bit of straw hanging out the back of your wig.
You had me going there. Mind, I did find some earlier, elsewhere.
Hey, have you had a word with Ashley?
Aye. I hope it's all sorted.
So, what are you drinking?
Rum and coke, please. Just go and get us a table.
Evening.
Hello.
Is Viv going to be joining you later, then?
I should hope so.
What's so funny about that? I think he's a bit simple.
Which would explain a lot. Uh-huh. He'd never have turned my head. I'll stick to Rock Hudson.
So what do you make of Marlon's plans, then?
Tell you the truth, not much. I'm used to being my own man at the diner, and I don't fancy going back to the temp agency.
So how do you fancy coming to work here? There's no way Marlon can carry on doing everything for us. Not with a restaurant to run.
You serious?
Of course.
Yeah, I'm really interested, yeah.
So, back at last then?
Oh, yes.
You're really into Viv then?
She's one of the most wonderful women I've ever had the pleasure of getting to know.
So, it is serious then?
Well, I think so. I mean, it is for me. And from what she says, she feels the same. We're an item.
Well, I've got to hand it to you, Marlon. You have proved yourself to be a most enterprising dingo with this restaurant venture. We're all dead proud of you.
Cheers, Zach. What are you hinting at?
Well, I presume you'll be wanting the diner refurbished.
Well, of course.
You're in luck then, see? Lisa and Jason are the best in the business.
Zach, it's a great idea, but oh, too late, I'm afraid. I'm already in talks with a couple of interior designers.
I see. I am very disappointed in you, Marlon. You can pay for your own beer.
So, not happy where you're living then?
Eh? Oh, it's not so bad. I'm not wedded to it, though. It can be a bit of a trek getting over here, even when I'm on the road.
You two look as thick as thieves.
Marlon, I've decided. Just so everyone's not rushing back and forth, divided in the loyalties, Carlos here is going to take over as the Woolpack chef.
What about me?
Well, it's the ideal solution. You need time and space to get your new restaurant up and running.
You don't need to go immediately, just when you need to.
You're the boss.
So you're agreed then?
I don't see why not.
Trivic.
The thing is, Bob, I know this might come as a shock.
Oh, yes?
I hope I haven't got the wrong impression. Only, I reckon I've seen you looking at me. And, well, the feeling's mutual.
Beg your pardon?
And I'm sure you'd prefer a younger model. So, how about it?
How about what?
Well, you and me. Forget Viv. We could have a good time together. Nothing serious, but...
What the hell do you think you're playing at? I'm not interested in you. I've never once given you encouragement. How dare you suggest that I have?
Right. Keep your hair on.
How could you do something like that? Making a pass at your own mother's boyfriend?
She ain't my mum. You just made a pass at me. He's just trying to get himself off the hook.
You lying toad!
Honest, Viv, you did.
I heard the whole thing, Kelly.
You evil little minx!
And what would I look at him for?
I don't believe this is happening.
You're welcome to him.
Come on, let's go.
She is dead.
off to?
Oh, are you going to curse your bladder when you find out what you've just missed?
I'm so sorry, Viv, but really, I didn't do anything.
I know that, Bob. I heard what went on, and that little cow's going to wish he'd never been born. Oh, I'm not too late
to get a pint of milk, Emma.
We are closed.
Just because you've met a new bloke, don't mean the rest of us don't exist, you know.
What's that got to do with anything?
I'm no threat to you.
Oh, shut your mouth.
You've gone too far this time. I want you out of this house and never come back.
Stop overreacting!
You made a pass at him in full view of everyone.
Only because I want things to stay how they are.
Yes, well, the only thing that stays as it is you. You're a nasty piece of work, Kelly Windsor, and so help me God, I disown you.
You disown me. I have never met a more vicious cow in all my life. My dad's better off dead than being stuck with a mad old tart like you.
Oh! Oh! Now that's enough!
Stay out of this, you! Who do you think you are?
You pack your bags now and get out!
Don't worry, I'm going.
I think I'd better get off and
Oh, no, Bob, stay.
I don't think that's a good idea.
We've got things to discuss. I mean, she's just making trouble. You and me have got to stick together. Bob, there's a home for you here. I want you to move in. Live with me.
I think there's a few things you need to sort out before you even start to think about asking anybody to live with you.
Bob, please, we're meant to be together.
No. Your family need you. I'm sorry.
We're going.
Home. Look, maybe I'll call.
Right, there you are.
I could have done better with my eyes closed.
Damn, you've seen through my plan to make sure you always do the cooking.
Thanks, Mark. I'm really glad we're together. You make me feel really good about myself.
Are you hungry?
No, not really.
No, neither am I. Shall we go upstairs?
We're all right here, aren't we?
Go on, we can lie down for a bit.
Look, I think I better go home.
Why? Oh, come on, no one's going to bother us up there.
Sorry, I just want to go.
What about your food?
So Bob tried it on. With you.
I didn't want to say anything before, but it's been making me feel uncomfortable ever since he showed up. Now he's trying to move in and all. I just can't take it anymore, Scott. I've had it.
So what are you going to do?
I'm leaving.
What, Mum's?
Nah, round here. I'm going to go back to London and stay with a mate till I decide what I want to do.
Kelly, do you know what you're saying?
I hate it here. And I hate the people. Apart from you.
Are you sure you didn't leave Bob on?
Don't you believe me? I don't have to go on my own, you know. You could come with me.
What, to London?
Well, why not? Be a new beginning for us. For the both of us together, like it always should be.
Yeah. No, I'm sorry, Kelly, but none of us need that. We're not meant to be together, you know that.
Go on, Scott.
No. No, I'm staying here. And you could too.
Nah. I'm off. I need to get on with my life. I just don't seem to be able to make things work for me around here.
Right. Well, if that's how you feel, then better go get packed.
So then, good day.
So. You?
Not bad. Rodney, there was something
else. Do you know, I was thinking what we were saying this morning about how to introduce me to Bernice. I've decided it might be better if I wasn't staying here when she got back.
Oh, right.
It'd be a bit abrupt. So I was thinking, I know there's no hotel, but how about if I moved into a B&B?
That's very thoughtful of you.
I don't want to upset her. Might be easier for her to cope with if I was at a distance.
Yes, you're right.
26 years is a long time.
Yes, 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 it is.
So I'll book in somewhere tomorrow.
Wonder where Mum's gone.
Don't know, and I don't care.
I suppose it's best she's not here. Kelly, where are you going to stay?
I've got mates. Stop worrying.
What are you going to do there?
What am I doing here? Collecting glasses in a dingy pub. I want to try and do something with my life.
You take care of yourself, eh?
What's going on? I'm leaving.
What do you mean?
I'm going to London.
Well, how long for?
For good. Look, I'll call you and explain it to you later, but I don't want you to worry about me.
Well, whereabouts in London?
Look, I've rung a mate and I'm going to stay with her for a while. I'll be fine.
Are you really sure about this, Kelly?
I've got to do something, otherwise I'm going to hit 40 and still be miserable. You've got to try and change things for the better, ain't you?
Kelly, don't go.
Be happy for me, Donna, because I might just manage to sort myself out. I'll miss you both.
Kelly, you can't just go like this. What's going on? Shall we go and find Mum?
No, I reckon she sounds like she means it. Good luck to her.